You know, Bill, it's funny, but somehow it seems like only yesterday to me that your mother and I brought you home from the hospital. And the first time she handed you to me, I was so nervous I didn't even know what to do. But as you smiled and grasped my finger with your little hand, I suddenly realized one thing, that I loved you. And I can remember many times gazing down at you in wonder as you lay fast asleep in your little crib. And every time you toss or turn or make a little baby sound, I'd lean close and I'd say,
one more time, baby Brown. One more time, baby Brown.
Somehow, Bill, when I look back on the next few years, it feels like they just raced by. And the next thing I seem to remember is that you were a big, strong, independent 17-year-old with a dad who still loved you more than anything else in the world, but I guess had the good sense not to tell you all the time. And I can remember many times gazing down at you in wonder from the grandstand at your high school football games. Handed you the ball, I'd yell along with the rest of the crowd when they'd say,
one more time, baby Brown. One more time, baby Brown. One more time, baby Brown.
And now that the guns of war have ended your short, beautiful life, and as I gaze down at you for the last time, you know what I find myself wishing, Bill? I wish that you were just a little boy again, sleeping up in your room the way you used to. And I wish that there was a circus coming to town tomorrow, and that when the sun comes up, I could go there with you. Oh, but more than anything, I wish there were no more wars, and that you hadn't died so cold and alone. My boy, my precious, irreplaceable son, when will we ever learn? And for just how long must there be?
One more time, Billy Brown. One more time, Billy Brown. One more time.